The Secret of Kells is by far one of my favorite animated films. It's got an amazing story, breathtaking animation, and a fantastic voice cast. I don't think it gets as much attention as it should, so I decided to make a video about it. And just a quick note, there will be spoilers in this video, so if you haven't seen the movie, I'd click off now. The Secret of Kells was produced by an animation studio called Cartoon Saloon. The studio was founded in 1999 by Tom Moore and Paul Young, who have been directors and producers for every film in the studio's history. If you haven't seen any of their movies, I would strongly recommend doing so. The Song of the Sea and Breadwinners are both amazing films that I personally think deserve more recognition. Oh, and by the time this video is out, Cartoon Saloon will probably have already released their fourth feature-length film, Wolfwalkers, which looks amazing, by the way. Anyway, back to The Secret of Kells. One of the best parts about this movie, and Cartoon Saloon in general, is the storytelling. The Secret of Kells is based on Irish history set in the 9th century during the age of Viking expansion. It follows a young spirited boy called Brendan, who isn't allowed outside of his village walls, but of course he goes there anyway. He then meets an old man called Brother Aidan, who is an illuminator, which is just fancy for book decorator, as well as the author of a mystical book called The Book of Iona. Brother Aidan takes Brendan under his wing and encourages him to explore outside the walls. Brendan then starts illuminating a book called The Book of Kells. While in the forest, Brendan meets a young girl called Aisling, who can talk to animals. They run around the forest together, and they become quick friends. They then discover an evil god called Crom Cruach, or Crom Chili, or something like that. Anyways, the Vikings then threaten to invade and destroy Brendan's home. But Brendan's uncle, the village leader, believes that their walls will be able to withstand the Viking invasion. Naturally, he was wrong. In the end, the Vikings easily destroy their village. Brendan is led to believe that his father died in the attack, but then finds him 10 years later, still alive in the ruins of his old home. Brendan then reveals that over the past 10 years, he managed to complete the Book of Kells. And just like that, the movie ends. Now, this story might seem a little weird at first glance, but there's actually a lot going on here behind the scenes. First off, everything in this movie is based off of Irish myth or folklore. The Vikings at one point actually did invade Ireland, and they brutally conquered them, killing most people and burning their buildings to the ground. Crom Cruach, the evil monster Brendan faces, was actually a pagan god in pre-Christian Ireland. The only way to appease him was, you guessed it, human sacrifice. People would also sacrifice crops and food in the hopes that Crom Cruach would bless them with fertility, which is kinda weird considering he was a pagan god with an insatiable bloodlust. Furthermore, the Book of Kells is actually a real book made in the 9th century in Ireland, written and illustrated by monks. It has drawings of humans, animals, mythical beasts, and a bunch of other colorful stuff. It's also important to note that the Book of Kells is a biblical book, and is regarded as one of the most influential religious treasures in all of Ireland. This gives the entire movie a new meaning. But before we talk about that, let's talk more about the characters. Brendan is a brave and curious 12-year-old boy who wants nothing more than to explore the forest outside of the walls of Kells. He is the protagonist of the story and the author of the Book of Kells. Most of the time, we see events unfold from his perspective. Brendan is conflicted during most of the film. He wants to explore the forest and write the Book of Kells, but he also wants to make his dad proud. His character resembles that of a spiritual monk or illuminator, which is ironically what he ends up becoming. This free-spirited character is what makes him perfect for making the illustrations in the Book of Kells. Abbot Sialik is Brendan's arrogant and stern uncle. He's obsessed with building a wall around Kells, and is confident that it will keep them safe from Viking invaders.
We have one day before the Vikings attack Kells!
He's the reason that so many innocent villagers stayed and died in the Viking raid, when they could have run away and escaped with their lives. Despite the consequences of his actions, and I'm really sorry if I butcher any of these names, by the way, Sialik just wants the best for his son. He just wants him to be safe and not have to worry about the dangers outside of the walls, even if that means going to extremes just to prevent Brendan from wandering around in the forest. In the end, Sialik realizes his mistake, and Brendan forgives him for it. Aw, what a happy ending. Shame half the village had to die for it to happen. Aisling is a young girl who lives in the forest. In Irish folklore, she would be considered a fairy, since she is able to transform into and command wolves. When she meets Brendan, it's pretty clear that they have a strong connection to each other. As a result, they quickly become good friends. Near the end of the movie, Aisling actually ends up saving Brendan's life while he is escaping from the Vikings that burned down his village. Brother Aidan is a biblical figure. He is revered and respected as a legend, and is the author of the Book of Iona. This book is said to turn darkness into light, which, if you remember, was referenced back in the beginning of the film. He represents hope and light in a time of darkness. He accompanies Brendan when they escape the village and stays by his side until his own natural death. But what does it all mean? I think it should be clear now that this story is about darkness versus light. It explores the theme of spirituality and the importance of family and unity. It kind of resembles ideas of Romanticism, an artistic movement focused on highlighting the relationship between man and nature. Either way, the Book of Kells represents hope. Hope that things can be better than they are now. Hope that life can begin anew. Now, let's talk about the animation. I loved it. I've always loved hand-drawn animation, but this took it to a whole new level. The opening to this movie is now one of my favorite movie openings of all time. The animation is perfect, and the voice acting is chilling. Every frame has so much detail and passion that I just have to keep watching. The animators use storytelling and animation techniques that I've never seen. There was even this one scene where they split up the screen into three different sections and Brandon's just like walking up the scaffolding on the wall. And I was like, oh my god, that's so cool, I've never seen that before. And don't even get me started on the fight scenes. The fight scenes in this movie are breathtaking. When Brendan faces Crom Cruach, he takes a pencil and literally draws objects into existence. They're both flying in some dark watery void, and there are so many amazing colors and frames that I can't even begin to describe it. You have to see it for yourself. I could go on and on for hours about how amazing the animation was, but I'll save it for another time. The voice acting was also spot on. Fun fact, by the way, all of the characters in this movie had voice actors that actually matched the age of their characters in the movie. It makes it feel so much more immersive. There's not much else special with the voice acting, but that's because it's so good that you don't even realize it. And let me just say, the music is gorgeous. Even from the first frame of the movie, the soundtrack had me hooked. It uses traditional Irish instruments like dulcimers, tin whistles, fiddles, and a bunch of other instruments I can't even pronounce. I wish I could share the soundtrack with you guys, but I would get copyrighted before I could even say the words. Shrek is underrated. Jokes aside, this movie is an amazing blend of animation, music, and storytelling. The characters are well written, the art is beautiful, and the music is tear-jerking. It might not be Pixar levels of good, but it earns its place as one of my favorite animated films of all time. Thanks for watching. If you want more content like this, please consider leaving a like. These videos are hard to make. I mean, I have to draw all of these character poses, and I'm not even good at drawing. Anyway, I'll see you guys in the next video.